My name is Faith Oakley, and I have Duchenne Herbs palsy, or brachial plexus injury. It was a birth injury, so when I was born, the nerves on my spinal cord were completely avulsed, and they caused my right arm to be paralyzed. So I've never had the use of my arm. I've never known what that was like. And now I'm a freshman in college. This is my second semester, and I'm on a collegiate archery team, and I'm going to be in the 2024 Olympics for Paris, France, and I'll be on Team USA for that, which is really awesome. And that's always been a dream of mine. When I was in the fourth grade, I had a coach at my elementary school that really wanted me to shoot, and I said, no way, there's no way that's happening. I don't have enough hands, I don't want to damage my teeth or anything. But eventually I went to summer camp that year, and my summer camp counselor, she held the bow for me, and then I pulled back and aimed, and the very first arrow that I shot was a bullseye. And then after that, I just completely fell in love with the sport. And I went back my fifth grade year, the very beginning, and I went to the archery coach at that school and told him that I wanted to shoot archery. So he found a contact of another person who shot archery with one arm and got me a mouth tab. So I started shooting with a nylon mouth tab that I bit down on with my molars. And then I pulled back the bow, and then to release, I just opened up my jaw. And that worked when I was younger, but the older I got, the higher poundage I was shooting, and it was starting to damage my teeth, because when I was younger, I was only shooting 15 to 20 pounds. Now I'm shooting 45 to 50. So once I got into higher poundages and further distances, I couldn't shoot with a mouth tab anymore. So then we decided that I needed to switch over to a shoulder harness to pursue an Olympic career and a collegiate career even. And now we're here. So I had a shoulder harness made, and it was for archery. It was a shoulder harness, a lot like the one that we're making now, but it just wasn't properly made. It kind of dug into my sternum, and it restricted my breathing a lot. And when we first got it, didn't even shoot correctly. So we had some teammates who are engineering majors at our school completely take it apart and redo it and make it shootable even, but it was still so uncomfortable that I just could not wear it for more than 10 minutes without passing out. So I wasn't even able to use it in competition. I was only able to practice with it. So we knew we were going to have to do something else. So that's why we're here now. Seeing something like this made is so awesome. It's incredible to see how much work and how much thought process goes into getting something like this made. It's incredible, and I didn't even realize there was so much to it. And seeing the team work together, I've been telling my coach and his wife all week, I've never seen a group of people work as well as they do, like together. It's incredible. They know what they're good at, and they just complement each other's skills so well. And it's just really incredible to see, and it's just super interesting. This year in 2020, we're finishing out our archery collegiate season, and then I'll be getting ready for 2021 and 2022's season as well. And then during that time, I'm also training for the Summer Olympics of 2024 in order to shoot for Team USA in Paris, France. And that's a really awesome opportunity that's kind of just fallen into my lap here recently with all of the opportunities that I've been getting and the resources that I've been receiving. And a lot of doors have been opened for me here recently, but that's been a dream of mine ever since I was a little kid, and now it's actually happening, and it's incredible. So during that training process, I'll be doing a bunch of strength conditioning. I'll be doing a lot of shooting, and I'll just be living and breathing archery for the next 4 years, because that's what you have to do if you're going to be on Team USA. In order to be accurate in a shot for archery, it's really complex. You have one little detail different or wrong, then your whole arrow could be inches away from what you're aiming at. You have to make sure you do the same process every single time to the T. Most of it's mental once you have your muscle memory down, and you have to be able to let go of an arrow once it's already down at the target and you can't stress over it anymore, because if you do that, if you start stressing, then you'll start losing more and more arrows and your score will slowly get worse. Being able to fire it correctly and not be in pain and being able to breathe while I was doing that was actually really incredible. Like, I'm still smiling just thinking about it now. That was awesome. But it was so cool, and it made me really, really happy. And it was the first time that I've been excited to pick up my bow in a really long time, because it's not painful to do it anymore, and it's really cool. Mackenzie is awesome. As soon as we got here, you could tell that she was really excited to work with us, and she was really good about explaining the whole process and what she was doing and kind of just welcoming us into the Bremer family. This was the least painful process I've ever been through for this kind of thing. Before my old harness, it took me a really long time to get it done, and Bremer just completely, they took care of me in a really good way, and I'm really happy with the harness that was made.